Charlie here. Charlie Bronson. 2009. I'm in a cage in Monster Mansion, Wakefield Prison. I apologise. I can't be there for the premiere of my movie. The only reason because of that is there's two doors locked and bolted on my cage. And there's a 25-foot razor wire with cameras all over it. There's dog handlers. And on top of that, if I did make it over the wall, there'd be armed cops chasing me all the way down the M1. So I've had to give it a miss. Such is life. But I want to thank everybody involved in this movie. From the directors, from the producers, to the actors, to the writers, to all my family and friends who supported it. I thank you all. But a special big thank you to my diamond mate, Double Diamond, uncut, priceless, the one and only Mark Fish, OBE, CDM, Top Geezer. This movie you're about to watch would not have been possible without him. And he does it all for me. Not for money, for brotherhood, friendship, solidarity, support. So thanks very much, Mo. Just make sure you know I appreciate you. So does my family. Respect. And I guess the main man, the Bronson movie, has got to be Tom Hardy. What an actor. What a man. Max respect. I'm going to tell you a little story about Tom. You'll like this. You see, I'm a cat, Irish prisoner. And all my visitors and all my phone calls have to be vetted by the police and prison security. And when I applied for Tom Hardy to come and visit me, they fucking knocked him back. Do you know why? Because they didn't want him to play me in the movie. They did not want the movie. They done everything in their power to stop this film. And I ask yourself one question. Why? And I'll answer that. They don't like the truth. They don't like the facts. Anyway, they stopped it. I challenged him, so did my solicitor. Funny enough, they changed their mind and passed him. Gutless, spineless people. Anyway, first visit, Tom comes up to see me. I clock him. I think to myself, he's having a fucking laugh at me. Now, no disrespect at all, but I don't think he weighed 12 stone soaking wet on our first visit. He just played that Bill Sykes in Oliver Twist. So he was slim, good looking bloke, though. Good personality, lovely fella. I said to Tom, I said, you haven't had a laugh, have you, Tom? I said, I'm 16 and I'm stone solid muscle, mate. I've been training all my life. I can do 172 press-ups in 1 minute. I can do 94 press-ups in 30 seconds. That's over 3 a second. I'm the king of press-ups. I'm the strongest, fittest 56-year-old man on the planet. And Tom said to me, don't worry about it, Jess. They're flying over the personal trainer from Hollywood to get me in shape to play you. I said, but Tom, we've only got 6 weeks before filming. Looked into my eyes. And he said, don't worry. I'll sort it. But when he came back to see me, about 2 months later, he was bigger than me. I couldn't believe it. He had muscle where muscle shouldn't be. I felt his shoulders and his arms. He looked good. I said to him, I fucking love you, Tom. Respect. Brilliant. You look awesome. And that's how it took off. I've not seen the film. I probably won't get to see it either. But I know that Tom Hardy done me proud. My family love him. And all my friends love him. Respect to the man. No one else on this planet could have played me better than Tom Hardy. He learned to walk like me, talk like me, train like me, look like me. I even took shaved my mustache off to give to him when he was filming me. He had my tash in the film. So I was a part. I was out there for that film. Not a lot of people know that. I suppose I'll always be known in Broadmoor as the roofer. Because I pulled that roof off 3 fucking times. That was my hat trick. Of roofs. I spent more time on Broadmoor's roof than I did in my cell. I smashed it to fucking pieces. The 5 years I spent in that asylum, I caused an estimated £2.5 million worth of damage to their roof. I'm proud of that. I'm proud of it. I was up there 81, 83, and 84. And I loved it up there. I was free. There's nothing better than sleeping up on a roof in the biggest asylum in the country. It was beautiful. And every slate, every wooden joist that I smashed and threw off, every ceiling I demolished, all the electric wiring, all the plumbing, I enjoyed. That was the Bronson get back to him. Here I was. Woodhill Prison, ready to go to court. Must have been about 94, might have been 93. They've open the door to take me to court in the morning. I'm bollock naked. I've just got my boots on. And I've covered my entire body in black boot polish. My face, my head, my back, my arms, my ass, my legs, everything. I'm black. I'm as black as coal. Like I've been on a two shift down the Main. I went to court like that, with just a towel wrapped around me. I stood up in the dock. I said to the judge, "Your Lordship, this is racial discrimination. You should have seen their fucking faces. You should have seen my face. All you could see was the whites of my eyes. I want to tell you a few stories. Because everybody loves a story. Especially about the asylum. And I'm one of the few geezers that's been in all the max secure asylums. Broadmoor, Rampton, and Ashworth. I've been in them all. And until you've lived in a madhouse, you've never fucking lived. Believe me. So you've met and lived with the insane. You ain't got a fucking clue. Seen it all. There's one geezer in Broome. Would have been about 1980. Got a bit of glass. And cut his bollocks. And pulled out a testicle. And fucking ate it. He ate his fucking testicle. And there was another one. He pulled out an eye. His own eyeball. And ate it. And over the years there, I've seen it all. Cut throats, cut wrists. Oh, there's one geezer there, cut his dick off. He actually cut his own cock off. Because they wouldn't give him a sex change. So he ended up with a pair of bollocks with no dick. It's sad, really. It really is. My life, my journey, has now cost me 35 years. And make no bones about it. I really was a nasty bastard. A horrible, violent, nasty man. And I'm not proud of it. But I'm not ashamed of it either. Because every punch I've ever slung in my life, I've taken 21 back. I deserved everything I got. Everything. I don't cry about my life. Never have, never will. I'll take it on the jewel. Knock me out, I'll jump back. And I'll fucking knock you out. It's that simple. I'm in a cage, 24/7, year after year after year. I'm refused progress. They won't let me meet. Why? What I'm going to tell you now is going to blow you away. Nine and a half years ago, I gave up on violence. I'm now anti-violent. And I've been for nearly 10 years. I've changed, I've grown up, I've matured. I'm a different man. When my visitors come to see me, the screws here in Wakefield, always say to him, Charlie's doing well. We don't even know why he's here anymore. He's no problem. He's a changed man. Should be let out. I've done my time. More than my time. I'm not a murderer. I'm not a rapist. I'm not a paedophile. I'm not even a danger to the society. I'm a hostage of my own past. I've got 12 published books. Go in a shop and buy them. See the new me. I'm an artist. Some of my art sells for a couple of grand. One sold for £3,850. I'm 57. Nearly 60. And after all this time, I'm now ready to go on. Anyway, as long as my mother enjoys the film, I'm happy. I'm not into the glamour and the sensationalism. I'm just me. Me, Charlie Watson. But I'm proud of this film. Because if I drop dead tonight, then I live on. People can see what I was, what I once was. All the best. Have a great 2009. I'll see you at the Oscar Awards. Over and out.